Musicians in bars getting bigger. It's Ready the Prince. How's it going, guys?
Good. We are Ready the Prince. We're from Toronto. We're playing at Horseshoe Tavern tonight. We're really excited. We released our last EP, Note to Self, last summer.
Why don't you introduce the band?
I'm Steve. I play bass and I sing.
I'm Daniel. I play guitar.
I'm Jordan. I play drums.
We started as an acoustic duo and then just kind of getting the ropes on writing music and all that stuff. And then we really wanted a drummer and just keep moving from there.
Right.
So we talked to Jordan, who was 2 years younger than us. And then we jammed and then Ready the Prince.
I was born.
Yeah. Right on. Yeah. So what high school was it?
Cardinal Carter Academy for the Arts.
Was it all based on that acoustic thing that you started from back in the early days?
Kind of. That was just like how we learned how to write songs.
Okay.
Yeah. But like we don't play any of the songs that we played back then anymore.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. We
a lot different.
Yeah, it's completely different. That was like more pop.
Oh, okay.
But it was like good for us to like learn how to write and sing and all that.
Sure. And so what influences?
One of the bands for me was Kings of Leon. Me and Jordan were big Kings of Leon fans.
Oh yeah.
When we started out playing in a band. They were like the band that like
I think inspired me the most. Yeah. Inspired us the most, I think.
Yeah.
Right.
Individually we all kinda have
different influences.
Our different influences that bring the band kinda together. I really like Queens of the Stone Age.
Right.
Great songwriting. Arctic Monkeys are great too.
And so how does the songwriting happen now that you're three people instead of two?
It's a little different. A lot of times me and Dan will kind of get something going with like, because he plays guitar. Guitar and vocals are a lot of the meat and potatoes of the song. Right? Yeah. So we'll make sure that's together and then we'll start arranging it with Jordan on the drums and it just kind of leads different places. Everyone kind of puts their two cents in and we see what works and listen back to the recordings. Like we record every jam.
Yeah.
So we're just constantly listening back and changing things we don't like and seeing what works. And
yeah.
Sometimes we get lucky, we just write it all in one jam.
So when did you start? How many years?
2012. So.
2012, so five, 6 years sort of thing? Yeah,
We did a big tour this summer that just passed in 2017. We toured, we did 11 shows, which is like a lot of shows for us, like all in like 1 month. Mm-hmm. So we did like Ontario, Quebec. That was really cool. We did a lot of it with our friends, Cleo Patrick. They're good friends of ours. But
that was this last summer?
This is last summer, yeah.
Ontario and Quebec, and where were some of the places that you played?
Played Montreal. We played Montreal like 5 or 6 times.
Now. What venue there?
We played the Vitrola. And we played Casa.
Mm-hmm.
Most recently. We went back in the fall and played, played there. Yeah.
Where else would you like playing on
that? Oshawa.
Oshawa was good?
Mustache Club. It's a great song. We're playing all the songs from the EP like for a while. We're really happy with the EP and how it sounds. So play a lot of music. I bartend down the street.
In Toronto right here?
Yeah.
Wayne Street.
It's called Peacock. They have last call 4 a.m. tonight, so we'll be there tonight
after
this place closes.
Yeah, exactly.
You're curious.
Yeah. You probably won't see this in time, but the after party is at the Peacock.
Yeah,
it was a good time.
Let me tell you,
it
was sick.
It was sick.
Yeah.
So, any challenges from the recordings?
It was recorded in 2 days.
It was recorded in 2 days in June.
Two days in March. It was ready to go. We just had to get like the
artwork
and stuff together. Yeah, we did it with Anton DeLost.
Uh-huh.
He's a local producer. So he did our EP before then as well.
Right on.
But yeah, he's
so that's your second EP.
This is our second EP, yeah.
And he did both of them.
He did both EPs.
Right. Yeah. Okay, cool.
So yeah, he kills it. He's awesome. So we did that in March in 2 days and 3 songs. That was it. We just wanted to get like, because our EP prior was a little bit of a different sound. It was more pop, a little bit less hard rock. So we wanted to put something out that defined more of what we were currently.
I think the biggest challenges were just that kind of time constraint that we had.
Yeah.
Because obviously it'd be nicer to kind of take more time with things like vocals or whatever, but with a little time, it's a little harder. We didn't have enough time. No.
Yeah, that's
but but the vocals sound great. We did it. It's just a nice challenge that we had. That was one of them.
Yeah, it's
doing it in 2 days is
it's tough. Yeah,
it's brisk. Let's just put it that way. You know.
Well, that's what we wanted to go for. We wanted to go for a raw,
real.
Yeah, we did the bass and drums live off the floor.
Great.
Yeah, so we just wanted that sound. That turned out great. Very natural sounding. We're gonna be recording a new single in March, and so we do it for the music. We do it because we love music. We want to change rock. We want to be one of the bands that brings it back to the like forefront, you know.
Interesting.
We take a lot of pride in our.
How are you gonna do that?
I don't know, by coming in with a fresh kind of like new sound. I think that rock and roll is kind of taking a back seat in the game right now to other genres of music. So sure. Eventually, it's gonna be a time where it comes back.
Especially live, like raw rock and roll. Exactly. You know. Yeah.
A lot of real drums, real bass, real guitar, and all that.
Yeah, it's just us. There's no click track. There's no, backing tracks. It's like, this is what we are.
If we make a mistake, screw it. I mean, we practice as much as we could, but...
Oh.
A little water,
huh?
Okay, that's... It's like
Freddy the fucking Prince!
It sure is!
That's organic.
Whoa! It was like an episode of Batman climbing up the wall.
That's
thank
fresh.
Thank you very much.
Very
Elvis has left the room. What inspires the writing?
Our lives. The things we go through.
Mostly relationships with emails.
No, not necessarily.
Is it love related? Is it love songs?
Some of it.
A couple songs.
There's a couple of love songs, right?
Just a couple.
We've all been heartbroken at one point.
Oh, yeah.
No, never. It's lying.
I'll say it. I have.
What a loser. No, other things too, like the song Note to Self off the EP. That one's kind of like a
Note to Self, really.
It's literally Note to Self. Yeah. Like looking yourself in the mirror and just like deciding you want to be a better person.
That's awesome.
That's pretty much what that song's about, you know.
Self analysis.
Yeah, exactly. So that was kind of the
Did thing. Everybody contribute to that, or is that your self analysis?
Lyrically it's just me, but I mean, for the most part, we kind of go through the same things. We're in similar situations, so it's like we all relate to what we're all going through.
You guys are bros. You hang out all the time. What's up?
Yeah.
We hang out a lot.
We hang out a good amount, but we're also young, pretty young guys.
What do you do other than jam together?
I don't know. It's like sports. Like play outside, hit the gym.
Occasionally play some tennis.
Yeah, play a little tennis. Okay,
cool, cool. So what was your worst class in school?
Mathematics. Brutal. Brutal. Unbelievably. It's embarrassing.
Yeah, math is probably my worst too.
Francais
over there.
Mm-hmm. Francais, that's the only word I learned.
Francais?
Yeah.
Wow.
That's good shit. All day. Toilette.
So what's up?
Yeah, that's not that's right, but...
It's not right, but...
We don't mean to offend
it. Toilette. Let me leave. That's pretty much all I knew.
I can edit, so anything you don't like.
Yeah. That's fine.
Twilight's all right. we're in the Horseshoe Green Room. Ever played the Horseshoe before?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, several times.
Oh, yeah, really?
From the natives.
Yeah.
We haven't in a while, but we're really excited about it.
It's probably like our sixth show here.
Oh, is it? Oh, cool. Mm-hmm. And any other places in Toronto that you like playing?
That we like playing? We've played everywhere.
Literally.
Any venue that is like smaller than this place we've played, pretty much. So I really like playing... Do I like playing the Rivoli? It's a good spot.
Pretty good spot, yeah. What was that one that was on Queen that closed down there and it moved? It didn't close down, it moved to college.
Hideout.
Yeah. The old hideout.
The old hideout.
Upstairs, a Smiling Buddha I liked.
Smiling Buddha's tight. And cherry. So, who else have you done shows with that you maybe want to give a shout out to?
Cleopatra. Those are our boys. Awesome. We gotta shout them out.
Yeah.
They're great. They're from Coburg, which is just east of Toronto, about an hour and a half. They're awesome. Check them out on Spotify. Hometown.
And where do we find you guys online?
Everywhere. Spotify.
Bandcamp.
YouTube, Facebook. YouTube.
ReadyThePrince.com. Twitter.
Twitter, huh?
Yeah.
This guy's got it going.
Everywhere. Ready the Prince. It's easy.
Yeah.
Check it out. Just Google us. All right.
Ready the Prince. Thanks for being on Musicians in Bars Getting Beer.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us.
Cheers.